right, welcome back. That was the anthem here on Hockey Night in Fredonia. Although, actually, you heard Sweet Child of Mine, but it's crazy. Here's the ceremonial face-off between the brother of the assistant coach for Fredonia. Ceremonial puck drop. Mike Lysich's brother there. As the players retreat to their zones for their little pregame huddle, for their pregame huddles here. So Bogart, last time we saw him, there was quite a bit of a rough start, but that was early in the season, certainly. Fredonia, they have found their way a little bit so far here. 2-0-1 at home, exactly 500 for the record so far. It's 2-2-0 in the conference. This is another Suniac matchup. The Bears coming down from Potsdam, New York. Fredonia will be looking to make an impact tonight.
Definitely need to get the win here tonight. Get us above 500. It's not bad being at 500, but I mean, can't make the playoffs just by doing that. So
certainly
looking for that boost.
And if they beat a team like Potsdam, it'll give them momentum towards the rest of the year.
Certainly. It'll give them a good look going into exactly tomorrow when they face the Plattsburgh State Cardinals. Another tough Suniac matchup, but rough start at the faceoff. And the Fredonia forward there, Polachek, has to have a couple words with the ref. But we're finally underway as Potsdam gets the first shot right in on Bogart, but he makes the save.
Yes, 10 seconds in already. Got
Vander
the first
Esch.
Shot.
Vander Esch making the quick impact.
Yes, Vander Esch.
Yes. We line up for a draw to the left of Bogart. 24 there for Fredonia. Shot in, goes up high, over the net. Tyler Ritter with that faceoff win. He'll pick it up. Send it around the boards. Freeman tries to settle it down, but Young shoots it in off a steal. Bogart has to make the save. Tyler Young there from the scene in New York. That's just down the road from Potsdam. I've been up there a couple of times. Wild. That's all I'll say.
Long ways up there.
Yeah, very. Got to pass quite the number of nothings to get up there. Here's the puck at the far corner of the Fredonia zone. Sam Wilbur going for a hit off the boards. As Potsdam battles one towards center, but Fredonia will settle away as Jacob Hines sends it in. Shot wide there, goes settled into the corner. Number 7 for Fredonia, Todd Schaus. Potsdam from behind their own net, they reset and off they go. Off the stick at the board. Jimmy Morgan settling it down. Vander Esch picks up for Potsdam. A shot, it's just wide of Bogart. As Fredonia tries to come away with it, but it's loose, and Bogart's forced to make another save.
A few seconds right before that play, Fredonia was changing. Almost got called on that too many men, so glad.
Yes, don't want to make those mistakes early, as Fredonia is prone to do while settling into the rhythm of the game.
Yeah, the coaching staff on Potsdam was definitely looking for that call, but didn't happen.
Face-off exchange here. Number 13 for Potsdam settles in as they map possession in the zone. Sealed off as the puck crosses the red line. Now in the Potsdam zone. Ventner dumps it in at the blue line. John Ventner. Fredonia comes away with it. There's Jacob Hines at the far end of the red line. So we go for exchange. It's forced a dump there. Kyle Thacker The Potsdam suits sends it up for number 82. There, Anthony Marente. Fredonia gains possession in their zone. Only for a second as a loose pass across the ice. Goes around the whole zone where it's sent back in by Mike Freeman of Fredonia. Potsdam collects possession. Off the skate, though. And trying to regain control, Potsdam will ice the puck.
Yeah.
I have to say, this is quite the shock. Fredonia not with names on their jerseys.
Yeah, no, that's...
I apologize, folks.
Yeah, it's always difficult, so...
Taking it, Wilbur, number 11. I know that one. Marente, with it for Potsdam, goes up the zone. Hard hit to keep the puck from going any further. He's trying to move in. A shot. McMiniman makes the save. As we're now at the bottom of the Potsdam blue line, looking for it. It's sent in off for no one in particular, as Tommy Martin sends it up the ice. Hines helps it out a little as McMiniman catches from the side of his goal. And Potsdam organizes a rush the other way. Young for Potsdam shoots it in on Bogart, but it's deflected wide. And then Fredonia turns it around with it. A deflect sets up Young again for Potsdam with Guillory, number 7. But he gets to the net front late in time. And Bogart covers it up.
Yeah, no, good idea to cover it up. Didn't want to let that struggle on by.
Nothing wrong with settling things down if you're not doing all cylinders right off the gate. Take it nice and slow. Fredonia comes off with possession on that faceoff. Was a little out of control behind the net. Tyler Ritter can't pick it up at the red line, and it's forced to go back down into the defensive zone. Good poke check there. Get in on that play. Gets all the way down the ice. Polichuk with it, which is interesting.
So, one good thing you want to try and practice if you don't want to get icing, just try to shoot it right at the net. So hopefully the goalie stops it.
Certainly. I mean, any way you can get it on net, it's good stuff. Here's number 6 for Potsdam, sends it up the ice. As we go all the way down from the blue line, Fredonia comes up with it, but not for long as it goes right back down. Opportunity in front. Fredonia picks it up. And Todd Schaus sends it in on McMiniman. Nothing too much comes of it. And another stoppage of play. Very slow, very methodical for both teams as they ease back into it. This is the first matchup for both teams against each other, of course, on the schedule. We'll usually see Potsdam again, whether Fredonia's on the road or they come here to Steel Hall. One of the few teams that do that when it comes to the SUNYAC schedule. Wilbur wins the draw, and Jacob Hines immediately sends it on net. But it's taken away here. Horn for Potsdam is checked on the boards. Fredonia gains possession off that. A miscue in front sends it in on Bogart. Arm in the air. As play goes the other way, well, it looks like there's no call on the situation. As Potsdam regains possession. And number 13 goes up the zone. Fredonia collects as they organize a rush the other way. Jawinski with Freeman. Turns it in. Bogart makes a stop with his pad. It bounces back, and Fredonia, Luda, the Bears, get a second opportunity from the blue line. Here's Jamie Young with it. Gives it up for Potsdam. Martin sends it in on net. It's easily deflected wide. Thatcher going behind the net. Trying to go cross ice, but here's number 14 for Fredonia going up. Kyle Jolinski. Potsdam collects, goes the other way. Gil Hooley gets sandwiched in on the boards, and the whistle blows, most likely from an offside call here.
Yeah, definitely the past minute or two, energy is definitely starting to kick up. Off to a slow first few minutes, but getting it right where they need to go.
Both teams at three shots as we have the draw. Fredonia, Max Ross with it. A pass up to Jolinski. Polichuk has to catch it from the air. It's from the far corner with it. It's airmailed way down back into the Fredonia blue line. Ross gives it up. Here's open ice for Fredonia. Tracy tries to control it, but he can't. And it goes back down the ice for Tommy Martin, who's checked strongly. He gets back up. He's no worse for wear. Here's Solars for Potsdam. Passes to Richardson. As they go, the Sozalo. That's quite the name. Number 91 shot in. Bogart makes the save. A good shot from number 14, Mike Sweeney, at the circle.
But even a better save for Bogart there.
I'd like to have a little personal moment of gloating here. Virginia Horvath herself liked my tweet about the game. Hello, Ginny.
Very nice.
Dr. Horvath, how you doing? If you're out there, thanks for tuning in.
So, all the support we can get.
I retweeted it. Did you see that?
I saw that. Don't worry. Faceoff coming at the far corner of the Fredonia zone. Ryan Dunner makes the draw, but Potsdam has it. Here's Thacker, cross ice, good setup for Sozalo, but Bogart makes the stop. And then another chance from the opposite corner, but it doesn't get too far, and Bogart's able to find that.
Fredonia's been pretty sloppy with the puck so far. They've been turning it over a lot, and they're lucky that Potsdam hasn't capitalized on it yet, because a team this good will definitely capitalize on any miscues.
6-1-1, I believe, were the numbers.
Yep.
That is true.
Potsdam definitely a dangerous squad.
So you can't give them any extra chances.
They're receiving some national recognition out there. But Fredonia's a sleeper team sometimes. They can get on top of things if they need to. Certainly can't count them out all the way. Tyler Ritter can't pick up that puck, crossing the blue line into the Potsdam zone. Ross tries to juggle a little bit at the red line. And Fredonia is going to go behind their own net. Here's Polichuk blocking off Martin, but it's sent all the way down. No icing as it's from just inside the red line. Polichuk tries to send this up the ice. You go the other way with it. Potsdam coming across the red line. Goimong, number 13. Fredonia picks it up off out of the corner. Here's number 28. Seven sets it in. No dice for the Blue Devils as two good chances by Josh Biasulo and then Todd Schaus. But going from one side of the net to the other, McMiniman is able to get from point A to point B.
Yeah, that was a really good setup. I like that. Number seven, Mr. Schaus out there, if I'm saying that correctly, was set up to win, score there, but just didn't get it in.
Look out, folks. Fredonia's on the power play. A two-minute minor assessed to number eight. So a two-minute slashing penalty to Brett Horn there. Looks like on that whole point A to point B business involved some penalties.
So
Fredonia gets the man advantage here for the next minute and three quarters. As here's Jimmy Morgan with it. Passes down to Schaus at the far corner. Dunner. Up. It's tipped up and high on a shot from Tommy Martin. On last check, the shots were 3-3. Only we've gone up only marginally. Shots are now 5-4. And Fredonia gets the draw in the attacking zone. Here Wilbur leans in to take it against number 14, Mike Sweeney. Mike Sweeney's going to be thrown out, replaced with Paul Michura. Wins it back. A shot from the blue line. Good shot, but it's easily stopped there. Max Blitz with it.
It's deflecting lasers there.
And we'll reset like nothing ever happened. Sweeney and Wilbur again. Wilbur wins it. Ross, a shot in from Wilbur from the far end of the blue line. Polacek sneaks around net. Back to Ross at the blue line, but it's cleared by Sweeney as Potsdam makes the change. About 10:36. In this first period of play, Fredonia on the power play, just under a minute to go. Polacek with an excellent coast-to-coast fashion. No goal on that shot. What a play by Jacob Hines picking up that loose puck, but McMinimum was right there.
Yeah, no, he robbed him. Like, where are the cops right now?
They're on their way. Todd Schaus going to lean in for this draw. He'll win it. A shot in from Ryan Dunner at the blue line, but it goes high over the net. Dunner chases. Number 17 on his tail for Potsdam, Ben Mariano. Fredonia winds up behind their zone. Schaus sends it high, and it manages to stay just in play. That's impressive itself right there. Fredonia sneaks around behind the net looking for a wraparound opportunity. It's in the corner. Fredonia is going to still have possession here. Schaus, Tracy, cross ice. Tries to fake him out, but he doesn't make it. Schaus in on net, block down in front. And the power play comes to an end for Fredonia. Back to 5-on-5. A couple good shots on net, but some of them missed their mark a little bit.
Yeah, you can say that.
Here's Guimond with Sweeney, but he crosses into the zone offside. And we'll take to the neutral ice dot here. Closest to us on the for the NCAA logo. Gil Hooley takes the draw against number 12 for Fredonia. Tommy deflects. Hawking the red line into the zone. Fredonia with the opportunity. McMinimum eats up that puck before DeFelice can get to him.
Well, Fredonia has 9 shots on goal so far, but I think half of them have been pretty weak shots.
Weak shots indeed. Fredonia putting things on net that might not necessarily garner interest, but, I mean, if you look at it in simple terms, you put it on net, you got to see what happens to make that judgment. Fredonia, so far, doing everything to the best of their ability. Here's a nice interception move at center ice. Wilbur turns that one around as he dumps it in ahead of him into the zone. Jacob Hines pushes it just past a Potsdam player. Turning around there, trying to exit the zone with Potsdam. A couple interesting trick moves there. from Jimmy Morgan, but he can't stay onside.
And unfortunately, Haynes was just a little bit over, and before he knew it, Russo was blowing back to the dot.
In the neutral zone. So just to our right here, a couple swipes at the puck go. Miss their mark, and Fredonia is going to pick it up in the neutral ice, go into their zone. Pass to DeFelice, can't make them up, make the mark. It goes into the corner. Julinski and DeFelice in a battle with a couple Potsdam players. DeFelice comes away with it. A shot from Ross. It goes up high. Rather Blitz. Max Blitz from the bottom of the blue line.
Oh,
big hit there on 26. Colin Valentine.
That was by the head area, too.
Certainly. Got to watch out for those hits there. Colin Valentine attracting some attention as he's the lone man in on the Potsdam zone around four white sweaters. A shot in, we're in the zone. Polacek shoots it just wide of McMinniman's pad. Fredonia's going to come away with it. Polacek waits to be onside. A shot in, tries to go Feifel, but McMinniman makes the stop. Tyler Ritter from the circle.
Well, Fredonia's starting to put some better shots on goal there.
Definitely.
Especially that last one by Ritter. I did enjoy it.
Looking at 10 shots to 4 right now in favor of Fredonia, so that power play, they might not have scored on it, but it's definitely slightly tilting the ice in their favor right now. Off the draw. Carlson. Polacek tries to send it around the ice, loose, but Potsdam's able to control. Five-man pileup at the top of the blue line as we're now trying to pick this puck out from the bottom of the haystack. Potsdam's going to be the one to come away with it as Venter sends it up for Salzario. Solazzo, rather. It's going to take me a good 20 minutes to learn that name. A whistle as the puck dumps in over the head of Bogart. Methinks it'd be offside.
That is definitely the case.
The draw. No one in particular wins it as we're both stay in the neutral zone for the meantime. It sneaks in behind Josh Biasulo. Biasulo misses a pass chance here as Potsdam has an opportunity. Bogart. It gets under his pads, but he's able to get it up away from the net. In doing so, causes the net to become unhinged.
Yeah, it's a good little acrobatics there by Bogart.
Potsdam gets a good opportunity. You can definitely see the eyes the Potsdam players have here for these chances. They may only have four, but they were, for the most part, four well-constructive chances. Off the draw. Ross tries to go cross ice. For Biasulo. Jelinski there with him. DeFelice tries to chase it down. Can't. But Fredonia does still have it, though. Colin Valentine. With DeFelice, the far corner. Potsdam comes away with it, though. Good opportunity. Here's Jelinski looking for it. A shot in, and McMinniman stops it down. One-on-one action.
Ooh.
And McMinniman comes out.
That's a hard shot
by definitely.
McMinniman's still down.
Put a lot of strength into that one.
Get a little mustard there.
The old Wilbur lines up against Joe Gilhooley Freeman tries to shoot it in from the blue line, but it gets sticked down. Spring down, coming away with it. Potsdam makes their move. Here's Young. Shoots it cross ice. Just goes relatively wide of Bogart. Trying to get to it was Morgan, but he stopped. Trying to set up a nice play there for Young of Potsdam. Tyler Young, but he doesn't connect on that play. A shot in, I believe it was number 27 over there, who is now relatively on the ice, at least for a minute, gathering his breath. That was a shot from outside the blue. It's impressive.
Yeah, that it was. Oh.
So whoever hit number 27 is taking a seat in the box. Looks Sam Wilbur.
Yeah. Not good. So don't want to put this really good team on the power play. So let's see what our PK can do.
Sam Wilbur takes an errant hit against charging penalty against Sean Kasorski. There's your warm-up for the night there. A shot cross ice from Vander Esch. But Thacker maintains it does not leave the zone. Go up, Vander Esch. Back to Thacker. Vander Esch cross ice. Tries to set it up. Can't. Oh, they do. There's that power play goal we were trying not to give up.
That's what I was worried about, like Potsdam 6-1-1. So there must have been something right to get that power play.
That makes Fredonia 35 for 45 on the penalty kill this year.
35 for 45. About 4:50 to go here. Potsdam now leads 1-0 on a goal. By number 26, Tyler Young there was able to sneak across there. There was a good look on the zone on the far on the far side of the net. So that's where that goes. Fredonia trying to leave the zone. They're whistled. They're offside. Touchhouse appeals.
Here comes the pizza.
The pizza scream? Oh boy!
Definitely go for some pizza. Even though I ate before the game, there is always room for pizza.
Well, at the red line, Bender for Potsdam sends it in around the zone, far end. Fredonia's got to come. Fredonia's got to peel this one away here. Try and get a goal back. A shot in, blocked down in front. Another goal! That one sneaks over the shoulder of Bogart.
Bogart would love to have that one back. It didn't seem like he knew where it was.
Fredonia caught not looking.
Again, that was another turnover for the Blue Devils. They
got to
clean up their play here.
The Potsdam Bears pushing the Blue Devils defense to the breaking point here. Two sour plays close to the net. Mike Sweeney getting that goal. Out the draw, Thacker for Potsdam will once again push the Bears into the zone. A shot in, Bogart has to stick that one away. It stays in play. Fredonia comes away with it. Here comes Morgan speeding up the ice with Hines. A shot in, tries to golf it over the shoulder, but McMinimum tracks that one in midair to stop it. That's the speed Fredonia's looking for. Maybe even the playmaking.
Yeah, no. I mean, playmaking is an important part of the game. And if you get a good few of those players on your team, you should be pretty set.
So we line up for the draw there. Wilbur wins that one away, but Potsdam's going to get possession. Tries to stop it. Morgan at the red line. Trying to fight it forward. Here's Jacob Hines. Receives a nice pass. Shoots it in. McMinniman pads it away. At the blue line there, Sean Leonard shoots it in. It's now behind the net. Fredonia has possession back to Leonard. Goes up the line. Tries to tip it up there. Polacek with a nice move. But it doesn't get them anything as Potsdam comes away with it. Number 12, Martin, fighting that one deep, but Fredonia gets possession off that play. Here's Polacek shooting it, and they score! Oh, it's Victor Tracy looking, keeping his head up on the other side of the back of McMenamin. Good tap in.
That was a fast play, and looked like Potsdam wasn't quite ready for it.
That was a great pass by who was it?
Polacek?
Yeah, Polacek.
Yeah, great cross-ice pass to set up.
Like I said, playmaking.
For sure.
Fredonia definitely making some good moves in those last couple of rushes, and one finally pays off. It's 2-1 Bears with 2:51 to go. We're now in the Fredonia zone, coming away with it. Tracy saves that one. Passes to no one in particular, and Thacker picks it up, shoots it in on Bogart. He wrists it away. Ross going behind the net. They pick it up, Sweeney there to try and steal it for Potsdam. Gets a shot. It's high and wide from number 16. A stop by Bogart there.
Puck goes out of play.
Rather that. All right.
That nice netting catcher.
Fredonia lining up for the draw there. We have... Oh, it goes out of play again. DeFelice was that one lining up for the draw. Against Brett Horn, the goal scorer. The first goal scorer for Potsdam. DeFelice will come back around and face it again. Fredonia will come up with it. Here's Jimmy Young with a pass, looking for Jelinski. Doesn't make it. McMinniman standing tall in his own net. As a player goes flying over someone else's head. Horn out the far circle. Potsdam clears. This will most likely be icing.
You are correct.
What an opportunity. What an opportunity. We'll go back all the way down with a minute 48 to go here. Wilbur does not win the draw. Potsdam has possession. Rimon tries to get the play, but Fredonia plays the body to get possession momentarily, and Potsdam can do nothing else but clear the zone. Wilbur trying to chase it up the ice. Joe Richardson gets possession, dumps it back down. Mike Leonard, Victor Tracy. Pass up to Morgan, Wilbur back to Tracy, and Morgan, Wilbur. Venter in behind the ice. It's shot.
Yeah, I saw that.
Goes out of play. It lands up and where the top of the glass meets, it causes another puck to come back onto the ice.
Yeah, now the one he shot is stuck up there. it's a little.
That was
a little
great.
A little blooper there.
Fun stuff here. Here's 24 there. Tyler Ritter for Fredonia taking the draw. But Potsdam has possession here, forcing this one towards neutral ice. Tipping it up the zone. Ritter. And the puck is blown down. We go all the way down as it was an icing call.
seconds. Definitely got to win this defensive faceoff and not go in with the 3-1. So hopefully that does not happen.
False start. Linesman stops the play. That's winning the draw there. Bobby Polichuk suits it up. Awkward pass off Polichuk's skate. He doesn't make it. We're now fighting our way up. Polichuk has the puck from neutral ice, loses it, and Potsdam's going to turn that around. Here's here's Mariano trying to get this one towards the net front, but he's forced behind Bogart. Potsdam tries to keep it in, but he loses it. It's shot very far and very high, but somehow it stays in. But that's going to just about do it, though, as the clock runs out. At the end of one, Fredonia, they play a dangerous game on the power play and give up a couple early. But the momentum certainly seemed to even things out towards the end of the period.
That is true. But those first few minutes of the period, it seemed like they were just waking up. So definitely the more you got in the period, they got woken up, a few goals got scored. So hopefully they can transfer this energy to the second and get another one in the net.
Definitely. So at the end of this period, 17 shots for Fredonia to Potsdam to 17-18. the old generic visitor's name there, Potsdam. They got 10 shots. So Fredonia. Again, sort of dichotomy of situations. Fredonia being down, they have the advantage in shots. So you made the observation that's a lot of this kind of so-so shots. And that's, I think, a fair assessment of what we had here. Something to come away with, perhaps, to move into the second period.
Yeah, they started off getting not-so-good shots, but then they started getting some better shots towards the end of the period. Now that the score shows as they...
As the T-shirt guy rolls around on the Zamboni, I think we'll take a step away from the mic here. At the end of one period of play here, it's Potsdam 2, Fredonia 1. Hockey Night in Fredonia back at you. Jarrett Belschmander, Kevin Syracuse, Colin Woods will be back with the second period, almost at third, but here on WCVF. 88.9, the voice of the DVL 89.5, the Inferno. I believe we're talking through the shoutcast here onto the Fredonia Blue Devils website, so hello out there as well. And I also believe WNYF is carrying us. You can catch that live stream video through YouTube.com. Look up the WNYF TV YouTube channel and just head on over to the live video they got running. Should be right at the top of the page. Nice, neat, there for you to see. So all those places, check us out. We'll be back at you at the end of this intermission.
Let your heart.